So now a next topic we have to discuss about fiber optic instrumentation. Okay. What is in the instrumentation? Any idea? Anyone know the answer? Can you unmute your mic and answer me? What is meant by instrumentation? Any example of instrument? Any already heard to study in third semester measurement and instrumentation subject. Instruments means
measuring.
Yes, okay. It will measure the some quantity and indicate the readings. Okay, indicate the readings or show the readings of particular parameter. So it's like it's nothing like a it's some device, hardware device. The device can measure the maybe a physical or some other quantities like electrical or other quantities. Okay, and display the output. Okay, and it can be show the output maybe in a digital format or analog format, anything. Okay, so here what were the fiber optic instrumentation system available in current scenario? Okay, so various instrumentation system is there. Okay, same you have to measure the voltage and current and frequency. So these are conventional meter is there. Okay, you have to measure the voltage means voltage meter, you have to measure the current means ammeter, frequency means you have to put a some frequency meter. So power factor means using a using watt meter. Power factor meter also is available, and you have to measure the power, and using the power you have to calculate power factor also. It is possible, but these are the conventional measuring instrument. Okay, for conventional means, for example, you have to measure the volt means only you have to use a voltmeter only. But the same voltage and current and frequency some other parameters or other quantities to be measured using fiber optic instrumentation system also, it is possible. Okay, this unit last topic we have to study about these topics. Okay, so that's why I have told that means this is a simple examples for instrumentation system. Okay, here you have to know the introduction. What are the introduction now? Fiber optic instrumentation system. The communication engineer, okay, any communication engineer need the fiber characteristic. Okay, need the fiber characteristics to design the fiber optical and fiber link with an efficient waveguide without any loss or dispersion. Okay, so first point, every engineer should know the characteristics of fiber. Okay, because in currently in any markets, different kinds of fiber optic cables and fiber optic materials or like sensors and other devices are available. Okay, first you have to know the characteristics of particular device, and only you have to choose which device is adopted for that your application. Okay, so I have to the technique in measurement of voltage, so I have to choose the particular characteristics of fiber optic cable or other materials. Okay, otherwise I have to measure the pressure, physical quantity, pressure or temperature. So you have to change the characteristics of fiber optic material. Okay, so then only you have to select the proper characteristics of materials based on your requirement. Okay, so based on your requirement, you have to choose the particular characteristics. Okay, maybe a proper waveguide and a proper cladding material and proper combination of materials are added during the manufacturing time. Okay, so these are the factors to be considered. Okay, every engineer, every communication engineer should know the characteristics. Okay. And similarly, a fiber manufacturer, okay, and also manufacturer also need the fiber optic characteristics. Okay, so and the consumer, okay, consumer also know the concept of the characteristics, and also the manufacturer, fabricator also know the characteristics of fiber optic cable. So then only they have to manufacture proper system or proper instrumentation system for using customer. And generally, the fiber attenuation measurement, are used to determine the repeaters spacing and light source. Power dispersion measurements are used to determine the maximum bit rate. Okay, for example, a simple attenuation measurement. Yes, so attenuation means actually you have to send the signal through a normal cable or like a fiber optic cable. The signal can be transmitted from one end to another end. After signal transmitting from one end to another end, an input in it going to some distance, okay, the signal gets some losses, okay, in a normal conventional transmission method. So at the time the attenuation level is going to low. It means the transmission of bit rate is slow.
Okay.
So when you get the output, you cannot get the exact output. Okay, so so the output
class
of the output of
fiber
optic cable is going to very low bit rate. So it cannot perform properly for that particular input. So it's very difficult. So you have to using some techniques, you have to boost the signal in normal conventional method, okay. But in fiber optic cable there is no problem. Okay. Here we are using determining repeater spacing and light source power dispersion measurements used to determine the maximum bit rate. Here there is no problem. So everything can be measured in the maximum bit rate. Okay, so there is no problem in transmission time. And the refractive index profile management are known. The number of modes propagating the fiber and determine its numerical aperture. Numerical aperture is nothing but how much amount of the light source can be recovered from the output side. Okay, you have to give an input for a particular amount of light intensity, and how much amount of light intensity can be measured in the output section. That is a numerical aperture value. Okay, so that output can be changed in which parameter means refractive index profile. Okay, so based on the cladding material, so the your fiber optic core can be covered with some cladding material polymer material. Okay, it's a non-transparent material, based on that the refractive index will change. Okay, and you have to using multimode fiber optic technique, okay, multimode propagating fiber, and to determine the numerical aperture. Okay, so you have to determine the numerical aperture based on the refractive index profile. Okay, so numerical aperture is nothing but how much amount of light intensity can be measured in the receiver section. Okay, because some losses, some minimum losses will take place during the transmission time based on some various parameters. Okay, already you have to study in unit 1 different kinds of losses are available. Okay, scattering loss, absorption loss, linear and non-linear scattering losses. Okay, so various kinds of losses will take place during the transmission, but that losses are compared to our normal conventional transmission method, it's very very minimum. So then only you have to choose or you have to prefer fiber optic communication for all the data communication system. And next topic, you have to measurement of attenuation. Okay, attenuation is nothing but signal strength. Okay, just you have to measure the signal strength. Actually, you have to send the signal or send the light source. Okay, you have to study it in the fiber optic technique. You have to send the light source from one end to another end. Okay, for example, the attenuation level going to down. Okay, some minimum. Okay, so few amount of transmitted light can be going to losses. Okay, here how to measure the the attenuation level of your actual signal. Okay, it is a name, another name is by cutback method. Okay, cutback means just you have to, the output is going to an input section. Okay, that is the reference section. Okay, so cutback, you have to cut the signal and going to another loop. That means already you got to study in control system. That means a closed loop system. So already you have to know the concept, closed loop system. Okay, the signal again goes to input section. Okay, that is a closed loop. So that is cut and again back to the your input system. So that is called cutback method. So here first block is a light source, any light source, okay, either laser or normal LED or halogen lamp or something, any light source. Here I have to mention white light. Okay, maybe you have to use some white light. What are the white light sources available? Any idea? Anyone tell me what are all the white light source? Any idea? Which lamp give pure white light? Any idea? Okay, you have to try to know the concept. Okay, which lamp give a white light? And that light source can be transmitted to microscopic object. Okay, it is a lens. Okay, that lens collect the all the light wavelength or light source and give a single path. Okay, single path, it's going to interference filter. Okay, interference means your actual light signal only, actual radiation of light. Okay, that, for example, this light give a particular amount of radiation of light. For example, the illumination level can be measured by using some light intensity meter or lux meter. Okay, the exact name is lux meter. That meter measures the actual intensity of light. Okay, that light source only allowed to next section. So remaining environment light source, okay, other light source are filtered here. Okay, so it will send the actual light intensity. Okay, so here putting some light source, a light source having particular intensity of light, that intensity of light only can be transmitted through the filter. So remaining light sources can be filtered here. Okay, it's a filter section to filter the another range of another radiation level of lights. Okay, so it is going to chopper circuit. Okay, so here it will, maybe here chopper circuit, it will convert light into electricity here or something using some techniques. Okay, I will explain the report and later. And it's going to the monitor section, and another it's going to fiber optic cable. So in the fiber optic cable, here is the actual your core. That is your actual core. Here I have to put a two boxes here. These two boxes are cladding mode stripper. Okay, you have to remove the cladding material. Okay, so you have to remove the cladding material. Maybe some light source can be transmitted. Okay, it's transmitted to outside section. Okay. Okay, it's a cladding mode stripper. Okay, using stripper you have to remove the cladding material, fiber optic cladding material. Okay, and here using a detector circuit to detect the light source, and it is cut back to going to some amplifier unit. Okay, block an amplifier, some amplifier unit, the signal will be amplified. And maybe here is the lock-in amplifier. Okay, this area will lock the output of your that system and your reference signal. Okay, so both are locked here, and the data can be recording some recording instrument. Okay, using a personal computer or something. So what are all the what is the attenuation level is available in particular time. Okay, here reference signal is nothing but actual light signal. Okay, actual light can be transmitted here to taken as a reference. After that you have to monitor here. Okay, how much amount of data transmission will take place. Okay, here through the fiber optic cable, and ending side you have to detect the light source, and it will get back to put into lock in amplifier. Lock means the amplifier, it is amplifying only, it will lock, okay, it will lock the actual output, okay. So both locked value can be recorded in the recording end, okay. Here how much amount of signal strength is there after transmitting, here how much amount of signal strength is there, it will compare, okay. Yes, I have to explain here, okay, in detail, point by point I will explain now. So the light from halogen lamp, so here I have to take a white light, okay. Already you have to see in street light, okay, in street light two different colors of light is there. One is a light yellow color, okay, it's a
I think
one is mercury vapor lamp, it produces white light source, and the halogen lamp also produces one light source, pure white source, white light, and another some yellow color light, it will create, I think that light, sodium vapor lamp, okay, exact name is sodium vapor lamp, it will produce a yellow color light, okay. Already you have seen in street light or in towns, okay, they have to erect a large size of a tower, they have to fix the lamp, different lamps, okay. Mostly nowadays we have to use white lamps, okay. They are in sodium vapor lamps are replaced by now halogen lamp, or nowadays they have to halogen lamp also removed, okay, using LED light source are using, okay. So they, these are the lights creating pure white light source, okay. And here we take that light source can couple to the experimental fiber having a length of 1 kilometer, okay. It is a test circuit, okay. Here in the circuit we have to using a fiber optic cable to take a 1 kilometer length, okay. Yes, you have to roll it, no problem, okay. Simply you have to put a 1 kilometer length of your test fiber optic cable, okay, and you have to give a light source into the particular cable. So the lens are placed in front of a source and focus the light in the interference filter and monochromatic prism or grating. So any kind of filters can be using, you have to allow the exact intensity of light, okay, somewhere that means noise level can be eliminated, okay. So you have to focus the exact intensity of light. That light, the given wavelength, is incident on the chopper, which used to convert the DC light, DC, convert to DC and light into square pulse. Okay, here in chopper circuit, it will convert the light source into DC, and after that, light into square pulses. Okay, so DC means DC pulses, square pulses are creating, as well as it is converted into AC signal, and also sends to the reference signal to the lock amplifier. So that particular signal, here you see the diagram and actual light source and the microscopic object, it's a lens, it will collect the actual light source and it's going to interference filter. Going to chopper circuit, okay. That chopper circuit have convert the light source into your electrical source, like a DC pulses, and it will also convert to AC also, and you have to monitor the value, and the same you have to take a reference signal reference signal, it is connected to the lock amplifier, okay. Software, the monitors are used to view the intensity of the light beams, okay. Already I told that, okay, that monitor will monitor the your actual intensity of your light beam or optical beam. And next, the cladding mode stripper, so are connected to the input and output end of the fiber, okay. See the diagram, your cladding mode stripper, here the two boxes, it is a transmitting side, it is a receiving side. So both ends are,
sir, both
ends of connector, okay, both ends of cladding material, either transmitting and receiving end, okay, it is connected to cladding mode stripper. So here what happened means the cladding mode stripper is used to remove the cladding light or the cladding modes. Okay, here at that place, for example, here in that place cladding mode stripper, maybe you know that wire stripper enna pannum, it will remove the sleeve of your wire. The same concept here, cladding mode stripper, it will remove the sleeve of the your fiber optic cable here, either front end and back end. In between, no problem, there is no problem, it's actual cable, actual fiber optic cable with covered with the actual cladding and jacket or everything. Okay, and front end and back end, so both ends of the cable can be connected with cladding mode stripper. The stripper can remove the cladding material. Okay, so next, then the jacket of the fiber is placed in an index matching liquid whose refractive index is slightly higher than the cladding material. Okay, so in that place, the jacket material, okay, the outer case of your fiber optic cable is placed. So you have to remove the cladding and place the jacket and index matching, okay, index matching liquid whose refractive index is slightly higher than the cladding material. So you have to remove the cladding material inside the cable. Remove the cladding material and put the jacket material, and the refractive index is higher than cladding material. Okay, so just you have to know the concept. So first you have to remove the cladding, because cladding material is available inside the cable. Okay, cladding is a cladding is placed on after that your jacket material. Okay, thus you have to remove the sleeve and you have to remove the cladding material inside the cable, and you have to put the another material like higher refractive index of cladding material, that is a jacket material is placed. Okay, what's the purpose means, this arrangement is called cladding mode stripper. Okay, and that particular technique is called cladding mode technique. So why you have to using the technique means, the light will attenuate the light propagating through the cladding. Okay, so and the particular edathula pathinga light oda propagation vandu change aagum, because we have to measure the attenuation level of your actual signal. So you have to set a particular arrangement for cladding mode stripper. You have to remove the sleeve at that time, at that particular area the light propagation will come out. Okay, so after traveling through the fiber of 1 kilometer length, the given height reaches the index matched photodetector whose output is given to the block amplifier. Okay, here you have to send the light. Okay, so here for example you have to using the cladding mode stripper will attenuate the light propagating through the cladding. Okay, so you have to remove the cladding material and using the higher refractive index. Okay, so it will not transmit outside of light. Okay, the light cannot transmit outside because we are using higher refractive index material instead of your cladding. So total light can be transmitted through the fiber optic cable. We have to take a test sample of 1 kilometer length. So throughout the length the light can be transmitted, and given height reaches, okay, it will reach a maximum value, and the receiver section using a photo detector, it will detect the output. Okay, and that particular output is given to the lock amplifier. Okay, so lock amplifier ku send pannirum. After that, that particular lock amplifier delivers output to the recorder unit. Okay, so you see the diagram. So it will detect a circuit, it will detect and convert into electrical pulses, and is going to, and here using here also both front and back end, here using cladding mode stripper, because it will, the output can be taken from that particular area. Okay, and detector will detect the light source and convert into electric pulse and going to lock amplifier. That amplifier will record, connect to the recorder, or nano voltmeter. Okay, maybe it's like a recorder, recording unit, or a nano voltmeter. Okay, send the fiber, and the fiber is cut back, leaving typically 2 meters of the fiber, and the experiment is repeated. So here, once the electrical pulses are recorded here, okay, in recording unit, or otherwise you have to place a nano voltmeter. You will take the reading of your voltmeter reading, because you have to measure the electrical pulses only. Okay, so you have to measure the, because that voltmeter measures the reference signal and your actual signal. Okay, so both are going to nano voltmeter. It will compare that which one is high, that position, that side, it will reflect the pointer. Okay, maybe your reference signal is higher than the output signal is, it will point to the left side. Okay, and your output is higher than the reference signal is, the pointer will point the right side. Okay, that meter having either a positive or negative value, it is deflected in both forward and backward direction. Okay, it's linear initially in a 0 point in 180 degrees. Okay, so after that only, based on that input and output, it will deviate from either left or right side. Okay, so it is no problem. Just you have to put some recording instrument, it will automatically recording. Okay, like a different kinds of recorder, or we are using a normal laptop or PC or some other device. Anything, any recording instrument, you have to connect it, and the value is recording continuously. Okay, and here, so it is a one set of reading. So after that, you have to cut back, and then the fiber is cut back. Okay, you have to cut the fiber around 2 meter length. Okay, either front end or back end. Okay, you have to leaving the typically 2 meter of fiber, and the experiment is repeated. Okay, so after that, you have to cut the fiber optic cable in front end or back end with the 2 meter distance, and again you have to do the same test again, and you have to take the reading. So after 3 to 4 times, you have to cut the cable and take the reading for a particular attenuation level is for which level of attenuation is available. Okay, so the distance is now starting initially 1 kilometer. After that, you have to cut the cable of 1 meter on both ends, and you have to do the testing multiple times. If you take a reading set, okay, just you have to calculate the attenuation level, either is increased or decreased. Okay, here in this case, the output power is noted, it is PR or something PY. Some textbook are noted as PX and PY, some textbook are PR. Okay, that means receiving, I have to put a receiving, or sending means PS. Okay, anything here I have to put a PX and PY, PX input power and PY is output power. Okay, and this procedure is repeated for other wavelength also. Okay, first I have to give a particular wavelength applied. Okay, after that I have to change the wavelength applied, and again I will do the same test again. So the fiber attenuation can be calculated by the given wavelength. Okay, I have to give a wavelength of particular frequency level. It can be given as, okay, it is like an alpha, it's decibel per meter. Okay, it's decibel per meter. The wavelength attenuation level can be calculated end up using this formula. So there is no derivation, so you have to know the formula. 10 log of base 10 PX divided by PY divided by L. So L is nothing but length of the cable, how much amount of length we have to take a testing purpose. Initially 1 kilometer, after that you have to cut the cable 2 meters from both ends. Okay, so the distance will decrease. Okay, and PX and PY is a power level, PY is the output power and PY is the input power level. Okay, you have to take the reading from input and output powers. Okay, so you have to calculate based on that length, the attenuation level can be changed. Okay, because it is inversely proportional, the length increase, the attenuation level will be decreased. Okay, so in detail, you have to note the point, you have to increase the length of the cable. Length of the cable increase pannanum appadina, so automatically the attenuation level going to zero, because your signal amplitude is going down. So the length is decrease. Okay, so length is decrease, we have to reduce the length, the amplitude or attenuation level is going increase. It is inversely proportional. Okay, so based on that length, so the attenuation level can be slightly deviated. Okay, either increased or decreased. It is inversely proportional. Okay, so you have to find out the attenuation level using that formula, using cutback method. Okay, first you have to take a full length cable. After that, you have to cut the cable front end and back end, 2 meter length, and again you have to take a reading, and again cut the cable, and again you have to take the reading. You have to take a sample of few readings, and you have to calculate the attenuation level can be automatically increased. You have to cut the cable. Okay, you have to cut the, you have to reduce the distance. The attenuation level will be increased. You have to increase the length of the cable, the attenuation level goes down. Okay, so you have to find out the exact value of your attenuation level using that formula. Okay, and next topic is optical domain reflectometer. Okay, that's a reflection meter. Okay, so the signal is striking the particular object and it will reflect to. And again, you have to read the light source, and it can be show the particular reading. Okay, so optical domain reflectometers. Here, I have to put some laser source or light source. What is the light source? It's a directional coupler. It's a coupling with your fiber optic cable. Okay. And the launch light, okay, it will go into fiber optic cable and go into some strike and it will return back. That is the launch light means it is your input light, okay, it will go into fiber optic cable and striking some laser and it will reflect and come back to directional coupler and it's going to photodetector and photodetector direct to the light source into convert the light source into electrical burst and integrated circuits. It will convert the electrical pulses and it will exactly active maybe a weak signal and it will go into amplifier, log amplifier, and it will go into display section. Okay, so based on the light intensity and it is to be striking for a particular object and that object reflect the light source, the light source can be collector and photodetector and convert the light source into electricity. And it's going to amplifier unit and amplifying, and it should be displayed in the display section or recording in the recorder unit. Okay, so why that particular reflectometer is needed? What is the purpose? Means, for example, optical detector reflectometer is the instrument which is used to both laboratory and field measurement. Okay, for determining the fiber attenuation and joint losses and detecting the fault losses. Okay, so mostly it is used to detect the losses. Okay, maybe your cable is either to be cut, your fiber optic cable is to be got any physical damage or occur using this technique where the fault is occurred, because we have to erect the cable in underground means we have to difficult to find out the fault location. So you have to find the location using the technique, optical reflectometer technique, easily find out the where the fault is located. Okay, and also it will also find out the losses, joint losses. Okay, if joint, how much amount of losses will occur in joint, and also determine the attenuation level. Attenuation level also find out by using that particular meter. When the fiber attenuation is varies, the distance, then the OTDR, okay, optical detector reflectometer is the only instrument which can measure the fiber attenuation along the fiber optic link. Okay, so it is also used to measure the attenuation varies at distance. Based on the distance, the attenuation is automatically changing. The changes can be recorded or measured by using optical reflectometer. and it is a non-destructive testing. Yeah, that is a measurement. Okay, so the in that measurement, it's a non-destructive. So here we could not change or we could not destroy the particular amount, because in previous method you have to cut back method, you have to cut the fiber optic cable or both ends in every reading. Here we couldn't couldn't restrict you of any material. Okay, despite the any material location, the cable is available on the full length. I have to calculate the value of attenuation level. Okay, it's possible in that method, because that based on the reflection of light, it can be calculated. Okay, so what's the principle? Okay, in which principle the reflectometer can be working means. So for example, both scattering method, okay. Scattering means the reflection.
Sure.
It should be a reflector. And it is based on the measurement and analysis of the fraction of light which is reflected back within the numerical aperture of the fiber optic cable due to Rayleigh scattering method. Okay, so based on the scattering technique, you have to take the scattering light source, and we have to using to calculate the quantity. That means scattering means the actual signal can be striking some portion, some area. It will reflect. The reflected light can be measured in detectors. You have to calculate the numerical aperture based on the Rayleigh scattering. So how much amount of light intensity can be taken outside, and how much amount of lights can be reflected. So both are all equal. It's okay. So I have to give intensity of what in one more. It will not come to outside. It will scatter inside of particular place. The scattering light source can be detected with detector circuit, and it can be converted into electric pulses, and it should be recorded for our reference purpose. Okay. Maybe I have to explain the construction, and I have to explain working point. Here, a light pulse from the pulsed laser is launched into the fiber through the directional coupler, and scattered light from the fiber is received by a photodetector like a APD. Okay, it's like a photodetector name through the directional coupler, and a box car integrator is mainly used for improve the signal ratio. Okay, SNR is the signal ratio by taking the arithmetic average lower number of measurements taken to one point within the fiber. The integrated circuit is nothing but mainly used to improve the signal ratio. Okay, it will integrate. That is, integration means you will get the minimum input, it will get the output is maximum. Okay, it will. Is to improve the signal ratio by taking, how it can be calculated means by taking the arithmetic average or number of measurements. You are taking the multiple measurements, and it will convert to arithmetic average. That average can be used as exact measurement point. Okay, and the signal from the integrated is fed to the logarithmic amplifier, that is a log amplifier, and its output is given to the recorder. Okay, that is recorded in decibel unit. Okay, and recorder will display the average and measurement in successive point. Okay, in every each and every second it automatically measure. The measured value can be approximately it will take a successive points. Okay, it will take a randomly take a particular time, it will convert, it will take a average value. That average value will be displayed in the display section. Okay, because each and every time the attenuation level can be differed, so it will take a sample value. Okay, particular time, for example, based on the time, it will take a maybe I will show another diagram, it can be easily understand. Okay, let's see the diagram. Here the fiber optic cable, if you take fiber optic cable here, it is a launch light pulse. Here in that area is a launching light. You have to launch a light input of your actual core. Okay, here is a coupler, it's a coupling unit. It will connect to the, it's a front end, it's a connector, and fiber optic, you have to connect fiber optic cable. Maybe any fault occur here, this is assumption. Okay, so these are all the factors for assumption. Okay, assumption level. Here fault occurring means, here I have to consider as a fault occur here, and here fiber link. Okay, so here fiber optic cable connected to another cable, fiber optic link, and splicing. Through splicing technique means you have to join the fiber optic cable and fiber cord. Okay, there is a cord, it will connect it to another device, fiber cord. So here, see the graph. You take x and y axis, and x axis I take time, and y axis I have to take a reflected power. Okay. At the initial stage, so the light pulses. Okay, launch light pulses. Okay. Here I have to launch in the light. At that time, the reflected power, maximum power will, you will get a maximum power. Okay, the reflection from fiber end. It will be reflected here. And input coupler. So you have to go into coupler. Okay, that arrow mark going here. Here the value of reflection power is reduced because I took more space here. Okay, na edutha the front end na join panni coupling endo, I will take some distance. So in particular distance irukku adhigama irukumbo pathinga appadina then our fiber optic light source and automatically reduce. Okay, let's see the another diagram before I have to see the diagram. It's a pulse laser. I have to put a coupler unit here. Maybe it will take some distance, means the light source can be scattered outside of that coupling unit. Okay, I will not collect all the light source. Okay, so I have to put a lens or specific arrangement. I have to collect all the light source and connect it to your coupler. So then only you will get the exact maximum output. But I have to take some distance. More distance means the output power, reflected power going down. Some amount of lights can be lost. Okay, after that, after some distance, fault will occur. Okay, you have to consider as a fault. So at that place, the fiber optic cable may be broken or something may be happen, means again your fault loss. Okay, the reflect power going to down. Okay, நீங்க ஃபால்ட் வந்து லொக்கேட் பண்ணி ஜாயின் பண்ணிட்டீங்கன்னா அடுத்து நான் இட் வில் கோயிங் டு நெக்ஸ்ட் செக்ஷன், அதர்வைஸ் இட் கோயிங் டு ஜீரோ. ஆன் த பர்டிகுலர் டைம் த அவுட்புட் இஸ் கோயிங் டு ஜீரோ. பட் ஹியர் ஐ குடன்ட் மென்ஷன் ஹியர். அண்ட் நெக்ஸ்ட் போர்ஷன் ஐ ஹாவ் டு மென்ஷன் இன் ஃபைபர் ஆப்டிக் லிங்க் ஆர் ஜாயினிங். அட் த டைம் ஜாயினிங் டைம் த பவர், ஆக்சுவல் பவர், ரிஃப்ளக்ஷன் பவர் வில் பி மோர் தென் யுவர் ஃபால்ட் லாஸ். ஓகே, ஃபால்ட் லாஸ் அக்கோர் ஹியர் automatically the power going down on that particular time. After that I have to join, the fault will be recovered, and again I have to put a joining here because the broken of your fiber optic cable to be joined using splicing technique. At that time the reflection power will be increasing. After such time I have to fiber end. Okay, fiber optic cable at ending stage, it will give a normal out power output. Okay, it will give a normal light source going that. But here it is a maximum, here you have to compare minimum. So that is the attenuation losses. Okay, so some, it will travel the some distance, some light sources are going to loss, so your actual signal going down. Okay, it's not a steady state. Actually steady state vandirukonum, but steady state valla why here take place means some attenuation losses are take place during the transmission. It's a long transmission, so the attenuation losses will occur, so the output is going down slightly. And again the reflection from the fiber end, okay, you have to connect the detector circuit, you will get a maximum value and going to process. Okay, that is a simple transmission of your fiber optic sources. Okay, these are all the factors to be affected. Maybe your fault not, I will consider fault occur here. It could not fault occur means the losses, maybe the power sources or light sources can be transmitted here. Okay, so it is a maximum level and going to end. Some minimum losses will occur, you get a exact output here. Not a 100% exact output, some minimum losses will take place based on the attenuation losses. Okay. ஸோ கண்டிப்பாக நீங்கள் பிஃபோர் வி ஹவ் டு ஸ்டடி த சம் ஃபார்முலா. ஓகே, தட்ஸ் ஆல்ஃபா ஈக்குவல் டு 10 லாக் ஆஃப் பேஸ் 10 PX டிவைட் பை PY டிவைட் பை என் லென்த். ஸோ பேஸ்ட் ஆன் தட் லென்த் த அட்டினேஷன் லெவல் இஸ் கோயிங் டவுன். ஸோ யூ ஹவ் டு ரெக்டிஃபை தட் you have to put in some other techniques. Okay, you are putting some other technique, you have to boost the signal, or otherwise you have to receive the signal and again convert it into electricity and again put a create light source and again send another set of light to another cable. Okay, it is also possible. Here I have to mention here the signal from the integrated circuit to arithmetic logarithmic amplifier and accordingly. Okay, so how the graph works, explained here. The initial peak is caused by the reflection at the fiber end. Okay, initial peak caused by the reflection end. That is the initial peak. Suddenly light pass panna light source can be maximum level will enter. After entering that, going to coupling unit, and the reflection from the input coupler is a small increase in the reflected power, and there is a long tail caused by the Rayleigh scattering of the input pulse as it travels through the fiber link in the forward direction. Okay, so it is a Rayleigh scattering. It always sent to the long distance of the cable. It is automatically going to the forward direction, and due to the presence of fault in the fiber link, maybe a fault occur, means there is a sudden decrease of reflected power, and next peak is caused by the splicer joint. Okay, so if any fault occurred in your cable, so the power reflected power automatically going down. Okay, maybe you have to join the fault or clear the fault. You have to put a joining using splicing technique. You have to put a join, means again it will, some spikes is there. Okay, on the joint lamukum enna or spike create power increase or decrease, and again it automatically going to linear level. There is a sudden decrease of a reflected power, and next peak is caused by splicer joint. After splicing, finally there is a peak due to the presence of reflection of the fiber end, where the reflected power is more than that splice. Okay, here using the splicing technique, some spikes are going up and down, and it is always going to at end stage. We are using the joining technique again. You are using connector or reflection from fiber end, and it going to some peak and again going to active low, and it is detected by the some other electronic circuit, and it will be process the fiber input signal. So here, what you can understand in optical domain reflector meter, it is used to find out the fault location. Okay, maybe you have to erect a cable in underground, means it is easily find out the fault location area, some major application. Otherwise, it can be used as a find out the attenuation level. So, attenuation level find out control, that meter also very useful. Okay, because you have to send the light, and after that you have to send the light from one end, and another end you have to put a mirror. It will reflect and again come back to your detector circuit, photo detector, and it will get converted into electricity and going to accordingly. So based on that, you have to measure the attenuation level at initial stage and going full length of distance, and again you have to take a reading. So at that time, how much amount of losses, attenuation losses take place in that particular place is calculated by using that type of meter. It's also possible. Okay, for example, if you take a fiber optic cable, it's a lighting 1 kilometer, 2 kilometer, you have to send the light, you have to put a mirror and again reflector, and it will come to here photo detector will detect the actual value of light source and convert into electricity. And previously I have to get the exact reference value. It is also going to integrate, it will compare and give a particular amount to log amplifier, and it will going to display the particular value or record the particular value. So how much amount of attenuation level can be take place at initial stage? At initial level, minimum distance the amplifier, that means the attenuation level is high, it going to increase the length, it automatically attenuation level is going to down. So it is also can be calculated by this type of meters. Okay, any doubt? Now I have to take two types of device instrumentation system. One is measurement of attenuation level using cutback method, and another one is measurement of optical refractometer. That meter used to find out the fault location as well as find the attenuation level. So both are possible in that reflectometer. And attenuation meter only used for measurement of attenuation levels only. It is used by the technique of cutback method. You have to cut the cable from both the front and back end to 2 meters. You take a sample reading and calculate the attenuation level using that particular formula. That's all from the session. Okay, I complete the session. Any doubt? Any doubt? If any doubt, ask me. Otherwise, you have to put your name and address number in chat box, and you have to leave the session.